Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today we will be learning how to create translucent plastic materials in 3ds Max. Plus, I will tell you how to make this plastic look old or new according to your need. First, select the bottle. Create a new V-Ray material and assign it. Next, set the diffuse color to black. Since it's a translucent plastic, so I will set the refraction first and then reflections. So, go to the refractions rollout and change your refraction color from black to white to make it transparent. Next, I will change my glossiness value from 1 to 0.98. Remember, I am changing refraction glossiness, not reflection glossiness. Change your refraction glossiness to 0.98 because it's a plastic, not a glass. So I want to make it little bit blurry. Next, change the index of refraction or IOR value to 1.4. 6. This is the value for plastic. It can be little bit higher than this, but not too much. You can Google it. But I normally keep it to 1.46. Now render. Now guys, you can see that the plastic is transparent, but it's not looking realistic because there are no reflections here. Mostly, this kind of plastic bottles have reflection. But I also want this bottle to be not white transparent. I want it to be a colored plastic, not a white plastic. So to make it a colored plastic, you have to come to your refractions rollout and you have to come to your fog color. Now I'm going to click here. I'm going to first save my render. Then I'm going to make a region and I'm going to start my interactive rendering. I will start changing my fog color. This is the way you make the plastic colored. You can make it according to your need, but I want it to be like this. Since mostly this kind of plastic bottles have reflections, so I will come here and change my reflection from black to white and render again. Now guys, you can see that this bottle has reflections, but these reflections are extremely perfect. In plastic, there are some scratches, or you can say the plastic gets very quickly some scratches even if it's a new plastic. So to make it look more realistic, I will use a dirt and scratches texture in my glossiness here. I will be using this dirt and scratches texture in my glossiness. Plus, I will click here on show shaded material in viewport. And if you see it here, you can see this bottle is now having this kind of dirt and scratches all over it. And I'm controlling it using UVW map. You can also control it according to your need. Now, make sure this render is saved and render again. Stop the render. If you look carefully, this was my old render without the dirt and scratches texture, and it is with the dirt and scratches texture. So definitely now the bottle is looking extremely old. So I will name it old translucent texture. But what if you don't want an old translucent plastic material? I want the plastic to look new. Duplicate the material. give it a name. Assign it here like this and change the glossiness to 0.95 in this one, the new one. Now the first question that should pop up in your mind right now: why did I decrease my glossiness value to 0.95 when I am controlling it with a texture? So the answer to your question is that, yes, I know, when I put the texture here, glossiness is being controlled by this texture. But I did it for a reason, you will see in a moment. If you look at the render right now, you can see that this bottle looks old as it is being used for a very long time. But I want this bottle to look new. Still, I have to give it some scratches to make it look realistic. Not this much, but a little bit. So I will go to the maps rollout here. So I will go to the maps rollout here like this, this glossiness parameter, and change the glossiness to 20. And render again. You can see that this bottle is looking new and this bottle is looking old as it has been used for a very long time. Now let me explain you what I have done here. Glossiness value 100 means it will completely use the texture here or here. These are both the same textures. Glossiness value 0 means that it will completely ignore this texture here and only use this value. So when I set this glossiness value to 20, I am telling 3ds Max to use 20% this texture and 80% this value. This is the way you have full control on plastic old and new look. The more I am decreasing the glossiness value towards zero, the more the plastic will be looking new because it is not using this dirt and scratches texture. But the more I am going towards 100, the more it will look old. So guys, this is how you make translucent plastic materials. Now guys, I will quickly make another duplicate. This time I don't want a translucent plastic, so I will turn off my refractions and just give it a yellow color like this and change its name plus, it's all up to you. I can change its another color like this something and assign it to this one here and render it. So guys, this is how you make translucent plastics, old and new, and non-translucent plastics. It's all up to you how you are going to make it. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating guys. Bye bye.